Hi YouTube friends and welcome back. I'm Some Tech Guy and today I'm going to show you how to replace failed fans on the PowerColor Fighter card. This card comes in RX 6500, 6600, 6600 XT and 6650 XT configurations with a free fan version for the 6800. It's a great little budget GPU, if there's such a thing these days. It does have a fairly basic construction, but it offers great relative bang for buck performance. This card has two fans, fixed into the plastic shroud with three screws per fan, which is secured in place by four screws. This won't take long, so let's get to it. First up, let's unscrew the fans. We won't be removing them yet, but it's easier to do this step now. Next, the four screws for the shroud so we can remove this from the heatsink. There are two on each edge of the card. I will be giving some specific and important tips on how to source your fans a little later, so stick around for that. There are some common pitfalls when ordering fans that you really want to avoid. Now we can lift the shroud off. There is a cable from the fans down to the header socket in the bottom right of this image, so lift the shroud down and towards you. Once done, unplug the header. It isn't a great design with the header socket in an awkward spot between the heat pipes, but you can pull it from further up the cable to get it out easily. Give it a wiggle left and right to get it free. Next, we can pop the fans off the shroud. For the left fan, release the cable from the clips first so it's easier to do. Don't push the blades, but rather you can push the base of the fan, which should be slightly wider than the shroud, just like you see here. The fans are cabled in such a way that they can't just be removed. You first need to pass them through the shroud and they initially look like they won't fit through. You can see here that you can put one side of the fan up against the shroud and then it's easy to work the other side through the gap. If we take a look at the fans from my unit, you can see the model number of the fans that you will need to replace. As well as the model number, starting here with T1292, you can see it's a 12 volt, 0.5 amp fan. Note, the model number is for the fan itself, not the completed assembly of both fans and cables, so there is a little more to think about when you're ordering, which I will give you some specific advice on shortly. Okay, let's go ahead and fit the replacement fans back into the shroud. Again, you will need to carefully pass the fans back through the back of the shroud, like you see here. The fan with the shorter cable is on the right. Now, orient the fan so the screw holes line up, and then screw the fans back into the shroud. And while we do that, here are my tips on buying fans. Tip 1, you need to check not just the model number, but also the dimensions when buying. The diameter of the fans, the dimensions of the screw holes, and the fan depth are important and could be wrong on aftermarket units. Tip 2, check the cable lengths. I have seen aftermarket fans for various cars where the cables were different lengths, making it either hard or impossible to install them. Tip 3, check the electrical specs. I couldn't easily find a direct replacement, but I ordered some fans that claimed to fit the fighter card. The power draw was slightly higher, and although they worked, they did seem to cause some stability issues on the card. Don't let this catch you out. Now, push the cables back into the retainer clips like you see here. This will stop the cables catching on the fans, but also will make sure the shroud seats properly on the heatsink. If you don't do this, you may have cables get in the way when you're trying to screw the shroud back on. When putting the shroud on, you need to align the plastic tabs on the shroud just inside the outer edge of the heatsink, like you can see here. Now, before we screw it in, put the header plug back into the socket. It will be very hard to do once the shroud is on due to the limited space between the heatsink, the socket, and the heat pipes. Right, once it's in, let's screw the shroud back into the heatsink. even though a few parts are accelerated here, you can reasonably expect to complete this job in 8 to 10 minutes. So, thank you for watching, and I really hope this was helpful. And if so, then a like would be greatly appreciated. And please subscribe if other content like you see here would be interesting. And of course, see you in the next.